What's good, everybody? I'm back with my follow-up for the Biggie Spider-Man with, you guessed, Tupac, Venom. Here we are, dipping him in the bath. And now got him coming out with some nice finishes. Had to take him to the barbershop. All right, now after priming him, I got the face for the base coat. And now here we go with my airbrush and starting to do the Xenophil highlights. His is easier, like the Rock's, because he's ball headed. All right, and now we got his features done. Went in there with a black paintbrush and knocked that out for the details and got his eyes right. Now it's masked off and it's time to hit this body. I went with a marine blue mixed with some purple in it to give it that that purple-ish undercoat that you would see under the blacks when you see the highlights on Venom. Because, you know, yeah, black is black, but it doesn't look good if it's just black. You need some highlights in there to make it pop. All right. He's a little hard to get to because of the way he's designed, and I really appreciate my guy that designed him. His name is Donnie, and he helped with this file, and I really appreciate him. He shouted me out on Instagram as soon as he got this file posted, and I really appreciate him and his artwork. Now it's time for me to take over on my side with the artwork. I can sculpt, but I don't like to sculpt because it takes too much time. I'm a barber by day and I'm a retired Navy veteran, so I try to do as much as I can when I can. So if I have to take too much time sculpting, then I don't have time to do the other things in life. All right, got a lot of coverage here. So we're just doing some highlighting now on the muscle details. And gonna get this guy onto someone's table soon. There we go. Long process of doing this. But I was very excited about this one. Very excited. Love doing this. And with my paints this time, I used a combination of Wicked Paints, Vallejo, and Army Painter. And you're constantly at Hobby Lobby replacing these colors. Especially brown, black, and white. Oh my God, you're always in the store for these things. I think I'm gonna set up something on Amazon to keep an order of it coming a couple times a month. But hopefully someone wants to put this baby on their mantelpiece. I'm starting to print more, and I have a couple of these lined up already. Ready to get painted and shipped off to someone. Hopefully I can get a Etsy page popping. But yeah, this is my passion and it's never going away. Yeah. Now, after putting all these highlights, oh my God, I came in to do the white. It is not as simple as you would think. You know, looking at Spider-Man and Venom, you look at them and you think, oh, walking apart because, you know, their design seems so simple. But that spider will give you hell. The spider webs, it will give you more hell. So you have to be patient and trust the process and go slow. Also, invest in a headlamp with a magnifying glasses, because if you don't have that, you're not getting in there and seeing what you need to see. And sometimes you paint outside the lines when you're not getting close enough and you're just winging it from far away. But when you use that headlamp, you see, I'm using it right now, and I can see way more than I can with the naked eye. And I'm painting right on the lines. Even though this one, he's a little harder to get at to paint because of the way he's posed and the sculpt. You know, he has the Venom goo symbiote goo spread out, so it's kind of hard to get my big hands in. I'm 6'2". And 200 plus, sometimes it's hard for me to get my hand in the little things. Pause. But I can definitely understand if, you know, you want to, I don't know what I'm going to say. Sometimes you forget what you want to say if it's not scripted. You can see this is non-scripted. But I'm having fun with what I'm doing. And hopefully you guys take something from this. Please like and subscribe to my page. I'm getting more subscribers, and they're picking up, and I'm loving it. And I appreciate everyone's support that speak to me and all that. So please keep the subscriptions up and likes. And I'll keep coming at you with more stuff. I got a lot of stuff coming up because I printed a lot throughout the summer, and I got it coming. So don't worry, I got fresh stuff coming. I seen some stuff from Sanix coming next month, so I can't wait to show you what we have before Black Panther drops. I'm definitely gonna be printing as soon as my man Sanix drops his Black Panther sculpt. And hopefully you know, I'll be able to get back into sculpting also, because I do like to. I like to love to draw. I love to paint. This is my passion, art. I love cutting hair. Love showing things that I can do. I was actually a culinary specialist in the Navy, so anything dealing with art, I love it. I want to do it, and I want to show it to anybody that's willing to enjoy it. Yeah. Listening to Tupac right now, I got sickle cell. I was kind of ticked off at him when he came at Mobb Deep about the sickle cell. But, oh well. I'm a Biggie guy, but I still love Tupac. All right, here we go. This is the end result of what we have. Hopefully you guys like it.
Sister, over the years we was poor than other little kids. And even though we had different daddies, the same drama when things went wrong, we blame mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell. And who think in elementary? Hey, I see the penitentiary one day. Running from the police, that's right. Mama cast me, put a whoop into my backside. And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was a black queen. Mama, I finally understand, for a woman it ain't easy trying to raise a man. You always was committed, a poor single mother on welfare. Tell me how you did, there's no way I can pay you back. But the plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
Don't you know?